I mean, you're not alone. A few of us have. Jane Dupre is a Geraldton-based vet, and she and her partner, Graham Oates, they've had a few intriguing pets in their time, one of which is named Ruby. Ruby, the little ginger lion cat, they call her. She was so interesting, in fact, the pair has written a children's book about her. So I caught up with Jane Dupre to find out more.
So my partner and I were looking at ways of perhaps bringing in a small income while I'm on maternity leave, and we saw a little advert on the TikTok app about how to make extra money, and so we thought let's give it a go, and we wrote a little children's book, and Graham has found out how to publish it, and he's organised an illustrator, and it's come together really nicely.
You just
So,
got your newborn on your lap,
yeah,
playing around with the microphone. But it's such a 2020 story, isn't it? You've seen something on an app, you've given it a
it really
go.
is. Yeah, it's really funny. And it's really funny now too that like we're advertising it, and like people are like, congratulations, like as if like we've got it published, like it's like at a publishing house or something. We're like, oh no, it's just something that we've done of ourselves.
But it
So.
is still very, I mean, not everyone has done this. People might think about it, but not everyone actually goes to the lengths to get a book
And
actually
it actually
written.
was like a little bit of work, to be honest. Like I kind of got a little bit over it in the end, having to like send a little storybook to the illustrator, then they'd send it back and it would be wrong, and then you have to go back and forth, that kind of thing. So you can see why not everyone would do it. And it did cost a little bit of money, but in the end though, we're really happy with it. So we're glad that we've done it. Even if it makes no money, we're still glad that we did it.
Absolutely. So, can you tell me about the actual story? What inspired it? Where did it come from?
So the story is about our little ginger cat Ruby, and we adopted her from the Midwest cat shelter, and she came in and had a really lovely temperament. So and our other cat Heidi hates Graham, so I thought I'm gonna find Graham a cat that actually likes him, because he really loved Heidi, and he's really like a bit rejected that she didn't like him.
No.
So we got Ruby, and she was in season when we got her. So cats when they're in season can be a bit different to the them when they're not in season. So she was the loveliest cat. She absolutely adored everyone. But then when we got her fixed up, she kind of showed her true colors, and she actually didn't really like Graham as well. So and she became really frightened of everything. So she was frightened of our floorboards. She was frightened of just the house in general, and she just hid everywhere. And then one day she escaped. And she's decided that she actually loves our neighbour more, and so she's moved in with our neighbour
Oh
Meek,
no.
and that's what the story's about, because they really love her. But she still comes over and spends the nights with us, and we feed her in the evenings. But during the day, she's just all lives on Meek's veranda. So that's kind of the story about how.
So you've
Hello.
lost your little ginger
Yeah, we
cat.
kind of have, like, and we the reason that she's the lion cat is we got her clipped because she has really long hair, and when we brought the baby home, we were just finding hair everywhere. So we thought let's just clip her just while the baby's little, just so we don't have get hair all in her mouth and everything. And then when she got out, she was clipped, and she actually looks like a little lion. So she's got the fluffy head, the fluffy feet, and the fluffy tail. So we could hear the neighbors saying like, "There's a little lion in the tree outside." So that's kind of the gist of the story. So
That's beautiful. And as a vet, what has it been like to write about animals in this kind of fun way for young kids?
It's been a lot of fun, and so I've got so many ideas of other pets, and they're all true. Like I've got the next one I want to write is about our other cat Heidi, who she came in as a feral kitten, and to try and get her used to being around humans and the noises and things, I would actually have her in the cupboard at work. While I was doing consults, so I'd do a consult and then I'd open the cupboard, say hello, and then close the cupboard again just to get used to the noises. And one day we were so busy at work, I forgot she was in the cupboard. So and she spent the night in the cupboard. So I think that will be the next book.
Oh,
So all the nurse
goodness.
and the nurses were all horrified the next day, because they found because they come in before the vets, and I was in lots of trouble for like for weeks with the nurses. But yeah, she was fine.
I have actually lost a cat in a cupboard once. I went to leave for the day. I think I was going to work and I couldn't find the cat that I was taking care of anywhere. And I was opening every cupboard and every drawer and then sort of just popped out of one of the kitchen cupboards. And I thought, oh, lucky that I found
really
her
sneaky.
Before I had to.
They're
yeah,
really
they really are. But yeah. Some really beautiful stories that you kind of get out of it as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, and there's lots. But we'll see how this one goes because I think it was a few, probably $300 or $400 that we've spent on it. So it'd be nice if we make the money back, we'll definitely do some more and see what happens.
And the time obviously as well that you've had to go through to write it, find the illustrator and yeah. get it published online.
Yeah, and it really though, like it was quite easy. Like the lady's in Sri Lanka, so like we just email back and forth. The lady that does the illustrations. So yeah, it was a lot of time, but it was much easier than I thought it would be. So yeah, really happy.
So it's available online. Are you going to get it published?
Hopefully, yeah. Even just as a keepsake for us, and I think Graham wants to have the. Print it and then have a copy of it with no colour as a colouring book as well. So it has, and just give it as family gifts. So it's a story, half of the book's a story, then the other half is the story again, but for children to colour in the pictures. So
fantastic. Yeah, so. And you've got your own little ginger cat on your lap as well, yeah. with your daughter with her beautiful hair.
Little ginger baby, yeah. We're going to call her Ruby if she was born in July because that's the birthstone for July, but she came in August, so... Yeah, she's Percy.
She's Percy instead.
Yeah.
It's such a lovely story. Thank you so much for having time and sharing it with us today. And good luck on your future endeavours.
No, thank you very much for having us.
Jane Dupre is the author of a new children's book, Ruby the Little Ginger Lion Cat, alongside her partner, Graham Oates. If you do want to find out more, you could pre-order a copy. It is being released on the 5th of December online. Head to Facebook, Ruby the Little Ginger Lion Cat from Oates Publications, a Geraldton couple. And it's a really, really sweet story. Keep your texts coming through if you do.